chuta utataka nitakupama.
Hey guys, welcome back to our channel Integral Family Lungu, back with another reaction video. If you're new to this channel, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course do not forget to subscribe. Like I said, my name is Fanny Lungu, and on this channel we post reaction videos each and every day. So if there's something that you guys want us to react to, let us know by dropping the link in the comment section below and we'll do it for you. Check out our second YouTube channel called Fanny and Jesse 2.0. Head there, subscribe, and enjoy our weekly content. We've got a podcast called Diving In with Fanny and Jesse, and we have some amazing conversations which you guys do not want to miss. You can find us on iTunes, Spotify, Podbean, this channel, or our second YouTube channel for the visual. And we have a Patreon, you guys can feel free to become members and we'll appreciate. A big shout out to everyone that has subscribed to our channel so far. Thank you for subscribing, liking, commenting, sharing, everything that you guys do. We're very grateful. So thank you. I hope you guys are doing alright and may you stay blessed. A big shout out to the person that suggested this. Today I'm going to be reacting to 10 prophecies mentioned by Prophet Muhammad. So without wasting time, let's get into the video.
Muslims believe that the Prophet Muhammad shared many prophecies for the benefit of the Muslim community and also for the rest of the world. Not that Prophet Muhammad came up with these prophecies himself, but the belief is that he received them directly from God and then he mentioned them afterwards. Hey, how's it going, everybody? Welcome back to FTD Facts. My name is Leroy Kenton, and for this episode, we're going to be looking at 10 prophecies mentioned by Prophet Muhammad. Some of them are going to be found in the Quran, others will be taken from the Hadith, as well as other Muslim sources. All right, so let's start off with number 10. This prophecy is about the end of the world. There is a large amount of the Quran that talks about the events of the last days, the end of the world, and the Quran describes how the world is going to be destroyed as well as rebuilt again, and how the dead will be raised to life again, and that they're going to be judged and either go to paradise or they're going to go to hell. And the Quran also describes hell and heaven in great detail. And since the Prophet Muhammad was the person who recited the Quran, these prophecies of the end of the world are attributed to him. There's also a prophecy of Fatima's passing away. The belief is that the Prophet Muhammad prophesied that Fatima would join him first of all after his passing away. And before his passing away, the Prophet called his daughter Fatima to his bedside, and then he informed her that she would be the first among his families to join him after he passed away. And that's what happened. Fatima joined her father in death 6 months later. There's also a prophecy having to do with the fire mentioned by Prophet Muhammad. There's a fire that will appear from the bottom of Aden, which is in modern day Yemen, and it's going to drive people as they try to run away from it to the land of modern day Syria. Then there's going to be a horn that will be blown and everyone will be left in complete terror and horror. Number 7 brings us the prophecy of Pharaoh, that Pharaoh's body is going to be found. Now there's a big debate around this as to the identity of the Pharaoh in the time of Musa or Moses. However, it's believed that based on the Quran that it was actually Ramesses II. He was the Pharaoh at the time. So the Quran and the Bible state that Pharaoh was drowned in the sea. However, the Quran does differ from the biblical account, where it says that the body of Pharaoh was saved as a sign for future generations, and the body of Ramesses II has survived in a mummified form. So fast forward to the year 1881, this mummy was discovered among a group of royal mummies that had been removed from their original tombs for fear of people stealing them. So Muslims view this as a very accurate prophecy that the Prophet Muhammad had mentioned. Number 6 is a prophecy of Islam and Islam prevailing. Prophet Muhammad, he shares a prophecy that his religion would prevail over all other religions in the entire world. Now, specifically, this passage says, "It is he who has sent his messenger, Muhammad, with guidance and the religion of truth, Islam, to make it superior over all religions." And this is referred to in Surah 9, verses 33, as well as Surah 48, verses 28, and also Surah 61, verses 9 in the Quran. We have 5 more prophecies to take a look at in this episode. But before we get into the last 5, I'm just letting you know that we did a series about the 10 worst haram things in Islam. I have a link to it in the video description section below. It's a 5-part series where we explore things that are forbidden in the religion of Islam in hopes that people can, you know, see a different perspective of why certain things are forbidden in the religion. It also serves as a reminder for Muslims as well. So definitely check it out. Again, there's 5 parts, but you can start with part 1. I'll link to that below. Next up at number 5, there is the prophecy of 3 trials. It's believed that 3 trials are gonna hit the Muslim world before the Antichrist shows up. There's a trial of retreat and war. Then there's a trial of false happiness, and this is going to come from a man, a descendant of the Prophet Muhammad, but he will not be a very good person. People are going to start to resolve their differences with this weak and very unstable leader that's going to show up. Then the trial number 3 is that there's going to be a huge catastrophe that's going to hit every single person in the Muslim world, and when people start to think that it's over, it's going to hit them again. And at the end, there's going to be 2 groups of people. One group is going to be of complete pure belief, and the other group is going to be full of hypocrisy. Now, when this happens, Muslims are told to look for the Antichrist to appear at any minute. Another very popular prophecy is of Ya'juj and Ma'juj, aka Gog and Magog. They are going to be released. Their army is going to be swarming down a very rugged, elevated terrain, and they're going to come down to destroy anyone and anything that they can find. People will set up defenses in their cities, and it's said that Jesus is going to lead his followers to take up a defensive position up in the mountains. And then when they think that they have destroyed all those on the earth, Ya'juj and Ma'juj will try to kill those that are up in the elevated area. And that's when Jesus and his followers will pray to God, and God is going to send a disease that is going to completely destroy Ya'juj and Ma'juj. Then from there, there's going to be a heavy rainfall, and then the earth will produce its fruit again, fruit and vegetation. Ya'juj and Ma'juj, they're described as having round faces, very small eyes, and black hair with reddish yellow highlights. They're very monstrous looking people, but they still are humans. The prophecy of Dajjal is also a very popular one mentioned by the Prophet Muhammad. Prophet Muhammad told his followers that false messiah would come and misguide a lot of people. There's a detailed description of how the Dajjal is going to look. Prophet Muhammad said that the Dajjal is going to be blind in one eye, and he also said that the eye that's not working for Dajjal is going to look like a floating grape. Also, his complexion is described as being sort of like reddish white. The Dajjal is also going to have a prominent forehead and a very wide neck. He's going to be short in height, but he's going to be very, very, very powerful. He's also going to have a hunch in his back. He'll walk with his feet apart, not like a normal person though, so it's going to be a little bit different how he walks. The Dajjal is going to have long, curly, thick hair, and the locks of hair are going to look like snakes hanging from his head. It's also mentioned that the Dajjal is not going to have any children. Enmity among Christians is a prophecy up next. Enmity among the Christian denominations until the day of resurrection is mentioned in the Quran in Surah 5 verses 14. And this is what it says. And from those who say we are Christians, we took their covenant, but they forgot a portion of that of which they were reminded. So we caused among them animosity and hatred until the day of resurrection. And Allah is going to inform them about what they used to do. The last prophecy of Prophet Muhammad that I'll share in this episode is the prophecy of tall buildings. The Prophet Muhammad mentioned that there would be signs and forewarnings of the approach of the last day. He mentioned that barefooted Bedouins would be competing in building tall buildings. And today, if we look in the Arabian Peninsula, the Arabs, who used to be very impoverished herders of camel and sheep, they're actually competing in building the tallest towers. Some of them include the Kingdom Center in Riyadh, Saudi Arabia, as well as you'll see extremely tall buildings in different parts of the Middle East. So that's where we're gonna end off this episode, guys. This was a look at 10 prophecies mentioned by the Prophet Muhammad. Really hope you guys enjoyed this one. As always, I want to hear your thoughts and comments down below. Join in on the conversation. You can also check out our related videos. Again, those are below in the video description section. And be sure to subscribe if you haven't done so already, because we post videos daily here on FTD Facts. So every single day, there's always something new to learn. All right, guys, it's awesome hanging out with you in this episode. I'll see you next time.
P. people are very weird. Why would you want to steal a mummy? Why would you want to steal a mummy? Just doesn't make sense. And then do what with it? Otherwise, I think all these facts that he's mentioned, I've actually come across them through different videos that I've reacted to. So not many things were new to me, except one. I've forgotten which one it was, but just one. So I won't say much about this because it's facts. Because these facts were self-explanatory, and some of these things actually happening in this world. We were forgetting our culture. We want to modernize. We want to compete with all these other countries in terms of buildings, technology, whatever the case is. All the most of these things are already happening. Even for prophets, now we have a lot of prophets that are misguiding us, and instead of worshiping God, we're turning away because we're worshiping these people that we think God sent, which doesn't make sense. Otherwise, this was interesting. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course, do not forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in my next reaction video.